Welcome to the world of Pokemon Phoenix.
Hello world! In this new video we will discuss the procedure of how to arrange a new flight under the EU regulations started at the 1st of January 2021. The most important thing you have to do is plan. That is everything. So, I have checked the weather for today. It's grey, it's not sunny, but at least it's dry. This is important because you have to plan your flight at least 3 hours ahead. So you cannot say, okay, it's now sunny, take my drone and fly. You only can do that if you have a C1 flight, which is like the Mavic Mini. Every drone under 250 grams. That's why the Mavic Mini is such a big success. However, I'm gonna fly with a big one, so we need to do some planning. So first, let's explain how this works. We have three different flight plans. We have A1, we have A2, and we have A3. It's important to know that we are discussing the open category. So, what is A1? A1 is the class where you have a privately built drone or you have a C0 drone. A C0 drone is the class of the Mavic Mini, which means under 250 grams. They call it a toy drone, I'm sorry. Then the second class is C1. C1 is considered the hobby drone. This is every drone up to 900 grams. So we're talking here like the Mavic Pro or similar drones, Mavic Air. They are under 900 grams and they are considered the C1 class. Then you have the C2 class, which is the prosumer drone. This is a drone up to 4 kilograms. So this is like the Unique drones or the Inspire 1 or that kind of drones. And then you have the A3 class, which is everything over 4 kilos up to 25 kilos. And then we're talking drones like the Inspire 2 or the Matrice 200, the Matrice 300, those kind of drones. Okay, the regulations for drones, that's important. So if you fly in A1, they say you cannot fly over uninvolved people and not over assemblies. Uninvolved people is not where you say, okay, I'm doing a festival and you inform everybody, hey, listen, I'm flying with drones, or you are involved. An involved group is not something where you can say, okay, I have a large amount of people, let's say like a football game, and you tell everybody, hey, listen, I'm gonna fly with my drone over you, so everybody is aware, therefore they are involved. That's not what it is about. You need to have everybody under control. They should be able to have one eye on what they're doing, but also one eye on the operator or the drone. So you cannot fly over a sport game because they are not focusing on the drone and therefore they cannot escape if, for example, your drone falls down. So what is involved people is when you are with some friends and you want to make some selfies, you fly up, you take your photos or your video and you come back. Then everybody is focused on the camera and they can be safe. This is the same for the basically for every drone, including for the Mavic. So you cannot say with the Mavic Mini, okay, I'm gonna fly over a busy walking street because it's allowed. You can't. That has to be very important. It's a gray area, but actually it is stipulated quite well, and it's basically what I just said. You must be able to see and connect to the drone and the drone pilot. Therefore, sport games and that kind of things are not allowed. With a C1 drone, that's like the Mavic Pro and the Mavic Air, you cannot fly unintentionally over uninvolved people. So that is not allowed. Outside the Mavic Mini, every drone requires an online test. A2 is something we will not discuss here because then we're going a step further and you need to have a separate examination and study, and you have to do that at the office of your authorities. So you can't do that online. Training, yes. The examination, no. Then, of course, we have A3, and that's the heavy drone, like my Inspire 2. The big difference is, with that drone, you need to have 150 meters distance from a building area, a residential area, an industrial or recreational area. So, what does that mean? If you want to film a house that is standing alone, that is not an urbanized area or a residential area. If you have three or four houses, that is also not a residential area. If you have a real street with parkings, houses on both sides, then we're going to discuss like a commercial or a residential area. And there, of course, you cannot fly over. So you have some movement to play. But basically what they say is you cannot film in, let's say, a street inside a city or a village. If you have, like we have in Belgium, along streets with some houses on one side and nothing on the other side, that's not a residential area, there you can film. Is it interesting to get A2? That only depends if you want to film people. It has basically nothing to do with building areas. So even with the C1 drone, like my Mavic Pro, you can fly very close to houses and you can fly in urbanized commercial areas, in industrial areas, just not over people. Another big change is that the insurance. Before, it was mandatory to have your drone insured if you had a registration number on your drone, like which I had. With the new regulations, this is not required anymore. So if you have your personal liability insurance, the only thing you have to do is inform your insurance company that you are extending your liability with the flight of drones. I know from experience, because I have done this process already, that if you have a drone below 1 kilogram or 2 pounds, you don't need to do this. This is automatically insured, at least with my insurance company. But I think this is the general rule. Because my Inspire 2 is over 1 kilogram, I have informed them and they will come back to me if this requires an additional liability clause and therefore a little bit more expensive. However, it's still cheaper than when you have to have a separate insurance only for your drone. What is important to understand that this is only for leisure flight. So it is not for a commercial operation. For commercial operations, you are mandatory to have an insurance. Let that be clear. Okay, so we go over the process. What we're going to do is we're going first to see the weather. Then we will see if our area is safe to fly. After that, we will set up our program with the authorities and wait for their confirmation and approval. When we have that, we're going to set up our flight in DroneLink. And then, if everything works out fine, this afternoon we're going to do the flight. I have never done a panorama with my Inspire at 50 meters. So it is a nice test, because in this VL2 area, it's only allowed 50 meters. I can't do it with my Inspire in the city because it's too heavy. But of course, I can do that later on with my Mavic Pro. Then I can go to 50 meters, just to know. All right, that's about it. So let's start to do some programming. And we go over this step by step. This is a simple app from the Belgium Meteorological Service. This is our window. You can see it's cloudy, it's gray, but it's dry, so this is what we're going to use. To have a legal and safe flight in category A3, I need to stay away 150 meters from any residential area. As you can see, I have an orbit of 150 meters to stay away from residential buildings. That is an empty shed, which is not in use, and there is a parking place. So the circle is basically free of any problems and obstacles. To be clear, this 150 meters is for any drone above 4 kilo in category A3. So, like my Inspire 2, I need to stay away from this distance to be safe and legal. Because we are close to Brussels Airport and therefore in the VLL2 zone, my maximum altitude is 50 meters. In category A0, A1 and A2, you can fly closer to houses, but you cannot fly higher, so for every drone, VLL2 remains 50 meters. We have set now our takeoff point, and now we're going to select the position where we're going to take the panorama. I think this looks like a nice spot. When we have set all our parameters, it's time we go use this area and we will inform the authorities of this location and our time frame. After you have an European pilot ID and operational ID, you can log in to any European website. In Belgium, this is done by Skydrone. They control Belgium airspace. Log in with your account. Then you go to your account page. Now we set up a new flight in the flight planner. The Belgium page is in Dutch, English, French and German. We go to flights. We click the plus and we add our flight. So we have to give it an original name and a description. Click confirm. Now we have to set up the activity, which is photo and film. So we click confirm. Now you can see there is a green bar. That means it's accepted. Now we go for the second, identities. The category is open. The subcategory is A3, as we said before. And of course, we fly visual line of sight. And we have our second green bar. Now we go to the area where we're going to fly. The three colors stipulate the limitations. This is the VLL2 venue where we're going to do our flight. So we will set now first the parameters. Now you can see. We will take off and we will do our panorama within that small square. This is the square that the authorities will see on their computer when you submit your flight. Now we have the details. The only thing we have to do is set the altitude. This is 150 feet. The date and the time. According to our previous window, our time will be between 1 o'clock and 4 o'clock in the afternoon. When your details, the date, the time of takeoff and the time of landing are set, we can save. When we click on save, you see we have another green bar. Here you can see the geozones. So we are under Brussels Airport and we are flying in the VLL2 zone. The next one is the operator. I am the operator, so I confirm. And I have another green bar. The next one is the drone you will use in your flight. In my case, it's the Inspire 2. Confirm and another green bar. I can add more drones if required. And the last one is selecting the pilot. That will be me. Confirm. And everything is okay. You can add documents if you have special requests or special approvals or an order. And now I go submit. And it's submit and you can see it's approved. When you have submitted your document, you get an email as you can see that you have submitted the plan.
If it is approved or authorized, you get also an email, and this is your evidence if somebody will stop you and ask you what you're doing. If you decide to cancel your flight, you just click on delete and your flight is terminated and it will be closed in your database. In the first email, you will see that your flight has been submitted. And if your flight is approved, directly you will get another mail which stated that your flight has been authorized. This, of course, you can use for the authorities if somebody might ask questions what you're doing. For now, the Belgium authorities require you to call them 30 minutes ahead of your flight and when your flight is over. After the 1st of February, this is no longer a requirement. In DroneLink, we will set up our flight and our panorama with the correct parameters. The orbit is still there, it is 150 meters, we are correct. My takeoff point is known, my panorama point is known, so basically I can now delete the orbit. Now my location is set, I will set up the correct parameters. This is my tailor-made panorama for the Inspire 2. I reduced the height from 92 meters to 50 meters. All the other settings works fine and they are correct. These are the tailor-made settings because the standard DroneLink settings don't work. And of course, these settings are in the list in the repository on the shared drive from DroneLink. All settings looks good, so let's do a preview. About 2 minutes, I guess, and it is exactly 2 minutes, 21 seconds. 34 photos, that is exactly what I want. Okay, I have finished the flight and I also have compiled all the images. We are now looking at PanoTour Pro, where I have made the panorama, and as you can see, 50 meters for a normal panorama is far enough. So this was an extremely successful flight. Of course, the link is in the description below.